Hello guys, before we get going here, for this and the next, for the next couple of videos, we're going to cover the Crackdown games on the 360. We're going to start with the first one here, the original Crackdown on the 360. It's an exclusive to the Xbox 360. That's the front, the back, and it did come with a manual, which we may use. We may. We'll just have to see. And yeah, a little bit about this game. This is very interesting because the amount of exclusives on the 360 isn't large. So it's very interesting to see one that did successful here. So this game was released in 2007. It has 7.5 out of 10 on IMDb with about 200-ish user votes. On the Wikipedia reception page, Metacritic gave the game 83 out of 100. Itch gave it 8 out of 10. Eurogamer gave it 9.0 out of 10. GamePro gave it 4.5 out of 5. GameSpot gave the game 7.8 out of 10. IGN gave the game 8.8 out of 10. Well, XMUS gave it 9 out of 10, and Play gave it 8.5 out of 10. Reviewers commented highly on the graphics game, both in the detailed setting and large draw distances, and the cell-like shading of the characters. One up said that it's just better to let a game approach reality in its own aesthetic terms than to go hyper-realistic. XPlay stated, "It's an absolute blast to play, and arguably one of the finest superhero games I've made thus far." IGN said, "Overall, the thrill of jumping like a mutant kangaroo from rooftop to rooftop is unrivaled. Co-op play feature over Xbox Live was well-received." Eurogamer said, "Being able to pick and leap into any of your friends or even complete stranger cities is likely to keep the buzz going through." And 1UP agreed. Reviewers did critique the lack of any appreciable story within the game and how short the core game itself may be. IGN argued, "Crackdown won't last long unless something even the story and music are weak songs." This must be the devil, which is a little loud. I noticed that games on the system tend to play a lot louder than games on other systems. I don't know why that is. I'll let the devil play, though. Crackdown was not expected to be a good game due to it being tied to anticipated Halo 3 multiplayer beta. However, the game surpassed many expectations. In the review, GameSpy asked readers a rhetorical question. Notice that I didn't mention the Halo 3 beta offer during this whole article. That's because it's completely irrelevant when looking at Crackdown. It's a solid game that delivers exactly what it promises, a great sandbox to blow the crap out of. It was named Best Action Adventure Game by BAFTA and Best Use of Audio, and also won Best Debut. Yeah, this game did incredibly well. It's kind of a shame. I think a lot of it had to do with the fact with its sequel, which we'll cover in the next video, did not do as well from what I remember. And we'll get to why in that, but right now, let's focus on this here. Oh, look at that. Man, I have to say this about Xbox games. Alright, just say that. I say this about 360 games compared to PS3 games. There's something about the way Xbox handles things that just makes it feel more simplistic. Download a new game content, time trials, kill game boss faster than before, campaign, map, options. Let's look at controller settings. Alright, so we got fire throw grenade, then nade, press and hold. Sniper scope. Enter exit supply point, pick up object, press hold kick. Jump, press hold X, pick up weapon, press and hold, swap weapons, aim, precision, yeah. Sniper scope, yes. Crouch and steady aim, click that. Movement, city map is that, pause that. Target, that's on foot though. In vehicle, accelerate, next music track, previous music track, brake, reverse, yeah. Enter, exit, horn, handbrake, X, A, look around, look behind, steering air. Yeah, not much there. Alright. Aims and targets, achievements. Alright, so not much. A lot of this I can see is probably based more on the online portion of it. Let's look at it. So, You can co-op it. We're gonna play solo. And let's see. Got a lot of appearance options with these guys. I think we're gonna go with the first one. I like the first one a lot. How this goes. Now, since it's open world sandbox, I have imagined that there might be some dialogue set up, so we might sit a minute on some things here.
Is making its last stand in a high-security compound known as the Keep. Access is restricted, and our limited force of peacekeepers can barely hold the fort. Desperate times require desperate measures. The agency is exploiting the work of disgraced scientist Dr. Baltazar Chernenko. His controversial human modification program is now being used to create new recruits for the agency, new agents of justice, capable of unparalleled evolution and regeneration. The agency's first prototype is ready to take to the streets, and not a moment too soon. This is war, a war on crime. Welcome to the agency, Agent. I'm your main point of contact and the closest thing you have to a threat. I'll guide you and keep you informed of the latest agency intelligence to help you rid Pacific City of its three biggest gangs. Your primary objective is to remove each gang's kingpin. Los Muertos' charismatic Don Domingo El Brazo Garcia, the Volt's autocratic Vladimir the Wolf Golian, and the Shy Gen's enigmatic Wang. Agency intel suggests that you weaken each kingpin's defenses by locating and removing their generals first. It's time to get out into the field, Agent. We have some revolutionary new agency vehicles waiting for you at the base of the Keep. Garage. Stand on the purple authorization point to gain clearance, then choose an agency vehicle. Use the tunnels beyond the blast doors to drive to a district in the city. The district beyond that blast door is controlled by Los Muertos. Agency intel is now downloading to your personal network. Los Muertos, the dead, have rapidly grown from a petty band of Central American drug dealers into a significant narcotics operation dominating the two islands forming Pacific City's east side, a district now known as La Mugre, the dirt. The gang's death designation was originally chosen to strike fear into those who might dare stand in their way. Now their name is more associated with the consequences of their vile trade. Los Muertos are formidable fighters with remarkable brute strength and brutality to match. They are also renowned vehicle specialists, stealing and customizing the finest cars and vans before using them to great effect in crimes and getaways. Be aware that La Mugre's South Island is packed with rooftops that present an ideal retreat for athletic agents under extreme duress.
Sounds so cool. They really got that sound right with the car engine.
You need to regain control of agency supply points. These covert nodes are strategically placed throughout the city.
Man, this is so cool driving through this tunnel.
You need to take one back now. A marker on your HUD will show you the way. We sent peacekeepers to take back the captured agency supply points, but they weren't successful.
Hold on a sec.
Once you bring gang weapons back to an agency supply point, you can reclaim them from any available agency supply point.
God, I don't know what. Yeah, I don't really quite know what I'm supposed to be doing here.
Gang weapon to an agency supply point, agent. It will be added to the agency armory so you can pick it up from any agency supply point in the future.
I'm gonna go. Ah, frick.
Death is not the end. Advanced cloning technology makes reincarnation a reality. Replacement clone forms are always in hand, ready to receive your established personality and performance data. Agent, you should seriously consider reclaiming an agency supply point.
And he's shooting at me for not to my car. Oh shit, right up there, huh? Thank you. This is tough.
Agency marker on your tracker, agent. Then take back the agency supply boy from enemy hands.
This game reminds me a lot of RoboCop. In a lot of ways, like the announcer guy, the presentation, everything. Thank you.
barricade. You liberated an agency supply point. You can now travel between this supply point and the one in the keep instantly. Reclaim other agency supply points to open up even more shortcuts around the city. Your HUD software is now updated, Agent. Agency supply points you've reclaimed are shown as orange markers. Supply points still in enemy hands cycle between orange and white. Now let's show these gangs those claws. Peacekeepers recently captured this intel, downloading to your personal network. Now. Juan El Número Martínez is the eyes and ears of Los Muertos, and thanks to his loyal bangers, knows everything about anything on the streets. Residing in the heart of the multi-level hillside housing development on La Mugre Southern Island, this manipulative and malicious criminal also holds the Los Muertos purse strings. Martinez puts the gang's ample illegal earnings to especially effective use when threatened by hiring the best assassins money can buy.
Hey.
Your HUD software is updated. A distinctive gang marker now shows the way to this key gang member.
Kind of tricky to defend yourself in this, but, oh well. I think we're gonna call it good, actually. Yeah, we're gonna call it good. But yeah, guys, that was, Crackdown for the Xbox 360. This is a very good game, very solid. I enjoy this game a lot. I would definitely play this. You know what? It's weird, you don't see a lot of, like, sandbox games from the good guys' perspective. Usually they're conflicted characters or criminals. They usually don't do cops, and I kind of like that they did that. It gives me a lot of Spider-Man 2 vibes and Spider-Man 2016 vibes with it. I don't sense any flaws. The only thing I'm noticing is that it's very easy to die, but I don't know. Maybe there's something I'm missing. I mean, learning with these gen games and beyond, sometimes learning all the controls takes a minute, but not impossible. But yeah, I do like this game a lot, and it's a 360 exclusive, and this is definitely a good game to warrant that exclusivity, because it's one thing if a game's an exclusive and it's shitty or average, it's like, why is this on 360? I can see why this game's on exclusive to 360. There's a reason why, because it works with 360 the best, and it just plays well on it, and it's just a great game to have as an exclusive as well. But yeah, next time we'll take a look at the second one and see why that one kind of killed the momentum for the series for a while. So we're going to take a look at that as well. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. In case you want to chat with me, Mike, or anyone else at the Gaming Company, you don't want to use the YouTube comment section, we do have a couple options. The first one is we have a Discord channel. You can find a link to that about page / about section of our channel. We also have a discussion tab on our channel as well. You can access that through a PC. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like the videos, and have a good day.